What is up, guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. Today we have 62-41 for the FIFA 18 official player ratings. We are going to kick it off with the Afro Man David Luiz. 86 rated, has gotten a 3 downgrade in pace, which is a bit ridiculous in my opinion. Makes him not as overpowered as he should be, but in game we know he's gonna have like 90 pace regardless. So yeah, that's a solid card, man. Nice little upgrade for his Chelsea card, getting a bit on the older side now, but yeah, still a very, very solid card. Sergio Busquets gets still an 86 rated, didn't have the greatest of seasons. Even his pace is even lower now, man. I can't see anyone using him apart from SBCs, so yeah, he's not a usable card, but yeah, decent rating. James Rodriguez, the Colombian man, getting downgraded by 1, but still keeping around the same stats. Medium low work rates, which is a bit iffy. 3-star, 4-star, so great card overall, and I could see a lot of people using him in the Bundesliga. Colombian park in this arm, even the best defense with his combination of 85 shooting, 85, blah, blah, blah. Toby Alderweireld, 86 rated, 66 pace, 87 defending, and 80 physical, 6'2", medium. Looks like a very solid card for the Premier League. Him and David Luiz are probably going to be the two highest rated center backs in the Premier League. 86 Karim Benzema, 6'2", 4-star still. That 78 pace is like a 4 pace downgrade. 82 dribbling and 84 shooting, 77 passing and 74 physical, around the same stats. This guy hasn't been that great for Real Madrid in goal scoring terms, but he's still a very, very important player in making Cristiano the player he is and getting him to score as many goals. French forward makes up for his lack of speed and physicality with a top class 84 shooting and 82 dribbling, is has played a key role in Real Madrid's recent successes. His deadly ability in front of goal, I'm not too sure about that, EA, but okay. Cesc Fabregas, 55 in the top 100 list, high medium work rate, which is a bit interesting. Still 88 passing and 81 dribbling, and all-around card. I can't see people using him in competitive or meta teams, so I can see him being a nice SBC card, just like Benzema probably. Benzema will probably be used from time to time, but not as often. Isco, a lot of people are talking about him only being an 86 rated card, but you have to keep in mind he is a center mid. If he was a cam, he would be 87-88 rated, because look at those stats for a cam. The shooting, the passing, and the dribbling are fantastic. I think his passing should be way higher, his dribbling should be like 91, but his pace is a bit low as well. 3-star, 4-star for the main man, but yeah, this guy is going to be a great player, by far one of the most technically gifted players in the world. Hell yes, he is. Shooting also makes him a threat. We have 86 rated Harry Kane, 86 rated, how I said. Low pace, I mean, he's not the fastest of players. Decent passing, great shooting, finally getting some shooting he deserves, and medium kind of average dribbling, 6'2", high, 4-star, 3-star. Those work rates are a bit annoying. I can't see many people using him in meta teams, just how I've been saying a lot. We have Alexandro, probably going to be the best left back in the game. Those work rates, high, are incredible. 3-star left, but 5'11", has the height on him as well. The pace, the defending, the physical, the dribbling, the passing, and even the shooting is pretty decent. So yeah, a very solid left back for your OP squad. We have Felipe Coutinho, a left winger, 5'7", 4-star, 4-star. High is a bit... I don't like that. 82 pace on the low side, shooting on the low side, passing and dribbling very, very decent. If he was a cam, he would be way better, but I guess left wing is what we're going to have to settle with. We have Nainggolan, 86 rated. This card wants to load, but okay. 78 pace, almost in the 80 club, but not quite. 3-star, high. He's a very, very all-round. He's going to be great in the game, but that 3-star is a bit average, so I don't know. I think he's still going to be super overpowered with, like, Manolas and Florenzi and Perez and all them. We have 86 rated center forward Dries Mertens. Looks like an incredible card. 4-star, high, low, 90, 89, 82 for his main stats. For a striker, going to be a great player to use in your Belgian or Napoli squad. We have 86 rated striker Romelu Lukaku, a bit on the low side for dribbling and passing, but still has great pace, shooting, and physical. Medium is still a bit iffy, but 4-star, 3-star is going to be very solid for him. 86 rated center forward Thomas Muller, high, 6'1", 4-star, 3-star. Pace, dribbling, shooting, passing, and physical are average. Very bad, actually, for an 86 rated card, but I bet his in-game styles are, like, way better. I know this guy has, like, 99 stamina or something in-game. Handanovic, 87 rated. I packed this guy's red card last year, but yeah, 387 to 86 Looks like an overall very, very solid, solid goalkeeper for your Calcio 8 team. Andres Iniesta being downgraded from an 88 to an 87. Will he still be a walkout? We're not too sure. But pace and shooting has been massively downgraded. Those look very bad now. The same with defending and physical. His dribbling and passing is still very high and very, very nice. But I can't see people using him apart from SBCs, to be completely honest. Rakitic, same thing. He has like a very solid card in dribbling, shooting, and passing. His shooting is actually exceptional. Same with the dribbling and passing. But the pace, defending, and physical is lacking. 6 foot is decent. Three star, medium isn't that great either. So I don't know how many people will be using him. David Silva, we've already seen. I don't like that card at all. That shooting, pace, defending, and physical is very bad. I mean, I'm not expecting good defending, but dribbling and passing, just those stats won't make him a great, great player, in my opinion, in game. Gerard Pique, another bad card. Low pace, low physical for a center back, especially him. He should have way higher physical. Dribbling, shooting, and passing for a center back is irrelevant, but the pace is pretty relevant, and that's pretty low. So I can't see people using it at that often either, because he doesn't have that greatest of stamina either. But 87 rated Merrick Hamsik, 5-star weak foot, 3-star skills. This looked like a very all-round box-to-box great cam, best great center mid, probably gonna be one of the best center mids in the Calcio A. So he looks like a very, very solid and OP card to use. Just gonna be a great, great card for him and the Calcio A. So yeah, this has been the what is this, 62-41. Tomorrow we're gonna get like 40 to like 21 or 40 to like 19, so that should be very, very exciting. And then on Saturday probably, or Sunday, we're gonna get like 19-1, and that's gonna be very, very exciting and very cool to see. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Like, comment, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a fantastic day.